Hi everyone, today we'll talk all barrier to initiation and continuation sacubitril valsartan treatment of chronic heart failure patients. This barrier is the cost of medication. Chronic heart failure is first of all the result of disturbed neurohumoral regulation in patients with affected heart structure and function. Therefore, blockers of beta-adrenoreceptor, angiotensin-converting enzyme, angiotensin receptor 2, and aldosterone have become vital in its treatment. These groups of medications, scientists believe, have one weak point, as they do not influence that branch of regulation linked to the natriuretic peptides. At the same time, trials with synthetic natriuretic peptides, neprilysin inhibition alone, and dual neprilysin-angiotensin-converting enzyme inhibition proved unsuccessful. Studies with dual neprilysin-angiotensin receptor 2 inhibition of sacubitril valsartan demonstrated positive results, but only in patients with reduced ejection fraction. In the end, despite the enormous expectation, sacubitril valsartan was approved in the USA and Europe for the limited treatment groups of patients with a long list of cautions and contraindications. I want to add that the advantages of the combination sacubitril-valsartan were shown against enalapril only. Valsartan, however, is not the only sartan, and enalapril is not the only the best among the angiotensin-converting enzyme blockers. Although no one has yet consult the right to a combination of angiotensin-converting enzyme blockers and angiotensin receptor 2 blockers with aldosterone blockers and beta-adrenoreceptor blockers. That is why the advantages of the combination sacubitril-valsartan, even in the limited group of patients with heart failure, need to be proved against this and other known possible combinations of medications that used in clinical practice. Today, the main problem of the combination sacubitril-valsartan, to which I have paid attention, is the high cost. Lindsay Sangaralingham with colleagues highlighted this problem in the article Adaption of sacubitril valsartan to the management of patients with heart failure, and one of their graphs underscores the seriousness of the problem. As for my understanding, this combination has the right to be, but it is worth resorting to it only when other treatment options are depleted. In such situations, I follow the rule, measure 7 times, cut once.